Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome all of you to the lecture of thermodynamics 2 of week number 7. In today's lecture we will be able to learn about the basic concept of jet propulsion. But before understanding the jet propulsion cycle, the jet propulsion engine, we have to revise some basic concept of gas dynamics. So what is gas dynamics? Gas dynamics basically concerned with the motion of gases and its effects. The gas dynamics is totally different from the fluid dynamics, because gas dynamic consider thermal or chemical effects, while fluid dynamic usually does not consider thermal or chemical effect. Moreover, gas dynamics deal with the study of compressible flow when it is in motion, while fluid dynamics does not deal with the compressible flow, but they deal with incompressible flow. So gas dynamic concept is very generalized and have been suggested for supersonic flow, compressible flow and aerothermodynamics, etc. Now in this slide we will try to understand the concept of a gas dynamics and its significance. So what are the significance and application of gas dynamics? This field, which is known as gas dynamics, is equally interested for both mechanical and aeronautical engineers, but their way of analysis is different. If we talk about its thermodynamics effect, we will consider it in mechanical field. Moreover, if we consider its thermodynamics impact, then in case of thermodynamic, the object is stationary and the fluid is in motion. With this combination, we can study the gas dynamic concept. Where is this use? It is used in steam and gas turbine. It is also used high speed aerodynamics. It is also used jet and rocket propulsion, and it is also used high speed turbo compressor as well. In this slide we will learn about the difference between compressible and incompressible flow. These are basic concepts which need to be developed before understanding the jet engine concept. So a flow will be incompressible if the density remains nearly constant. Examples of incompressible flow are liquids flows. These are all liquids behave incompressible. Compressible flow are those flow if the density does not remain constant. Gas flow are generally compressible flow. Mach number, which is the ratio of velocity of the object to the velocity of the sound, is a very good indicator of whether the flow is compressible or incompressible. So if Mach number is less than 0.3, the flow will be considered as incompressible flow. If Mach number is less than 1, the flow will be considered as subsonic. If Mach number is equal to 1, the flow will be considered as sonic. if Mach number is greater than 0 or is greater than 1, the flow will be considered as supersonic, and if the Mach number is very very larger than 1, then the flow will be hypersonic as well. Now we will explain ideal jet propulsion cycle, which is our main concern of this lecture. So it is based on gas turbine cycle, which we normally known as Brayton cycle, but in case of aircraft, gas turbine operate on an open cycle which is not closed, and this open cycle is known as a jet propulsion cycle. This cycle is different from ideal Brayton cycle in a mode that gases are not expanded to the ambient pressure in the turbine like Brayton cycle, but instead in jet propulsion cycle they are expanded to a pressure such that the power produced by the turbine is just sufficient to drive the compressor and the auxiliary components such as small generator and hydraulic pump. We can say that the net work output is equal to the work of the turbine minus the work of the compressor. In this case, in an open cycle jet propulsion cycle, the net work is zero. The net work is equal to work of the turbine minus work of the compressor. So work of the compressor is almost equal to work of the turbine. So the net work in case of jet propulsion cycle is zero. Remember, the net work output of a jet propulsion cycle is zero because work of the compressor and work of the turbine are almost same. Now in this slide we will explain the schematic as well as TS diagram of an ideal turbojet engine. So first of all we will focus on schematic diagram of jet propulsion engine. The jet propulsion engine consists of a diffuser, a compressor, a burner section, a turbine and a nozzle. So the construction is also different from the gas turbine, stationary gas turbine power plant, because diffuser and nozzle are extra component added to the jet propulsion system. So if we concentrate it on the TS diagram of the jet ideal jet propulsion cycle, so from 1 to 2 is a diffusion process. Air from far upstream is brought to the air intake, which is known as diffuser, with some acceleration or deceleration. So at point 1 to 2, here remember, from 1 to 2 is air is decelerated as it passes through the diffuser. When air is coming from the atmosphere and passes through the diffuser, this air is decelerated in diffuser. So 1 to 2 is a diffuser process in which air is decelerated. Now come to point 2 to 3, air is compressed in a compressor. This compressor may be axial or centrifugal type compressor. So this is 2 to 3 is a compression process. 3 to 4 is constant pressure heat addition process. Here the air is heated using a combustion chamber or a burner section or a burner as well. Now come to process 4 to 5. Process 4 to 5, here in 4 to 5, the air is expanded in a turbine to obtain the power to drive the compressor. This is turbine expansion process 4 to 5. And from 5 to 6, process 5 to 6, the air may or may not be further heated in an afterburner by adding further fuel. Or we can say that the air is accelerated and exhausted through the nozzle. Remember, from 5 to 6, in simple words, from 5 to 6, the air is accelerated and exhausted through the nozzle. So this was the complete ideal cycle for jet engine. Here one thing should be remembered, that what is after burning? After burning used when the aircraft needs a substantial increment in thrust. For example, to accelerate to and cruise at supersonic speed. Since the air fuel ratio in gas turbine engines are much greater than the stoichiometric values, there is sufficient amount of air available for combustion at the turbine exit. Also, there are no rotating components like a turbine in the afterburner. The temperature can be taken to much higher values than that at turbine entry. So this point must be remembered. The study components consist in this slides. We have already described it, but moreover we can also describe further for your understanding. That in the schematic diagram we have shown diffuser. Along with diffuser we also mentioned compressor. Along with compressor we also mentioned combustion chamber or burner. We also mentioned turbine. We also mentioned a nozzle. So this text consists of its TS diagram and schematic diagram explanation. We have already explained it. One thing should be remembered, that in ideal jet propulsion cycle, the turbine work is assumed to be equal to the compressor work, and the net work will be zero, because net work is equal to work of the turbine minus work of the compressor. As I have already described, that a turbojet is a jet engine, and it is typically used in aircraft. It consists of a gas turbine with a propelling nozzle. The gas turbine has an air inlet, a compressor, a combustion chamber, and a turbine. The compressed air from the compressor is heated by the fuel in the combustion chamber and then allowed to expand through the turbine. The turbine exhaust is then expanded in the propelling nozzle, where it is accelerated to high speed to provide thrust. Now, what is thrust? Thrust is a mechanical force which is generated by the engine to move the aircraft through the air. Or we can say that thrust is the force which moves an aircraft through the air. Thrust is mainly used to overcome the drag of an airplane and to overcome the weight of a rocket. Thrust is always generated in the opposite direction from the accelerated gases. Remember, on aircraft there are certain forces acting: thrust, lift, weight, and drag. So the thrust developed in a turbo engine is the unbalanced force that is caused by the difference in the momentum of the low velocity air entering the engine and high velocity exhaust gases leaving the engine, and it is determined from Newton's second law. thrust can be found out from Newton's second law, which is equal to F is equal to ma. In order to analyze ideal jet propulsion cycle, we have already explained that thrust is work on Newton on the basis of Newton's second law, which is equal to F is equal to ma, where acceleration is change in velocity. Here, velocity at exit minus velocity at inlet is the change in velocity. So F is equal to m del v, which is equal to ma. Thus, for an aircraft cruising in still air, velocity at inlet is the aircraft velocity. Also, the mass flow rate of the gases at the engine exit and the inlet are different, the difference between equal to the combustion rate of the fuel. So, taking equation number 9-27 in consideration, which highlighted the basic of F is equal to ma. Using this Newton's second law, we will analyze ideal jet propulsion cycle. We are talking about the ideal jet propulsion cycle analysis. So, we have already described the Newton's second law, F is equal to ma. From this Newton's second law, we can calculate the thrust force, and also we can calculate the power developed from the thrust of the engine. This power is also called propulsive power, and this propulsive power is represented by Wp. Propulsive power is equal to F into V. V is the velocity of the aircraft. If we put F is equal to ma relation in equation 9.28, this equation will become Wp is equal to m dot V exit minus V inlet into V of the aircraft. So we calculated the propulsive power from this relation as well. In further analysis of the ideal jet propulsion cycle, the net work, which is equal to work of the turbine minus work of the compressor, is equal to zero. Hence, we cannot define thermal efficiency because the net work is zero. Instead of thermal efficiency, we can define a desirable efficiency, which is known as propulsive efficiency. This propulsive efficiency is equal to the propulsive power divided by energy input rate, which is represented by W dot P divided by Q dot N. So the ratio of these two quantity is called the propulsive efficiency and is given by equation 9.29.